I'm here with St. Joseph coach Pepe Villasenor. First off, thank you for letting us come here to St. Joseph, hosting Media Day. It's always a fun day. We have about a dozen area teams come here, so I know you got a lot on your plate with your first season here as a head coach. So I thank you for allowing us to come here and hosting that, so I appreciate that.
Absolutely, it's our pleasure.
And, you know, we're less than 3 weeks away from your first game as a head coach. Just what's your mentality right now? How do you feel emotionally? Are you ready for that first Friday night? How do you feel right now?
I don't believe we're ready, but we will be ready. We have high expectations, and we're trying to create a sense of urgency right now to be ready. Each and every day, we're working hard and attempting to be as disciplined as possible. And every day, we have our mottos in regards to brotherhood and working hard and finishing. And each day, we're thinking about, you know, being prepared to play tomorrow.
How has the transition been coming to the Central Coast? You getting comfortable here? You're enjoying your time so far? Have you been able to kind of enjoy yourself here in Santa Maria?
It's been fantastic. Everyone has been welcoming. It certainly is a little different from the South, but nevertheless, football is football. Young men are young men, and we're out here working hard.
Okay. Talk to me just about this group you have this year. You know, how would you kind of describe them? How is the weight room been? How is training been, practice? How would you kind of sum up this group that you have?
These young men have been fantastic. I've set their expectations high. I've demanded a great deal of them, and they are meeting those expectations and not afraid to work hard, getting up early and leaving late. Very much a blue collar mentality.
Who are some guys that you're kind of leaning on to not only perform on the field, but bring that leadership? You know, who are some guys who have stepped up so far?
Been very, very excited and happy really with everyone.
Okay.
We declared our captains today, and I feel each and one of the captains bring something different to the table. We have Chase Artopius, obviously the starting quarterback, who isn't really new to the area, but maybe new to the program. And he certainly has come in and made a name for himself and become an instant leader. Several guys, Alex Onoveros has been very vocal and dynamic for us on the offensive line. Mr. Maldonado's incredible, brings energy. I mean, each and every one of those young men have definitely contributed in terms of the leadership role.
All right. I got to ask you about your wide receiver group. You were, I'll say legendary receiver at St. Bonnie. Is that kind of something when you're running a practice, you want to maybe spend a little extra time with that receiver group? Do you feel like, you know, that's kind of your specialty? Talk about your receiver group a little bit.
I do. I spend as much time as possible, but I've designated a wide receiver coach, and I have to be able to hold that wide receiver coach responsible to develop those young men. I mean, my focal point is definitely offensive line, defensive line, and the quarterback is in reality, that's where you win and lose games. But I will say I'm very OCD when it comes to my wide receivers.
Okay, and talk about Artopius a little bit. What does he bring to the table? How would you kind of sum up what he adds to the team?
He brings a great deal of composure. Okay. I've been, he has very good arm strength. He identifies defenses, which is very exciting to me. A lot of times at the high school level, you get quarterbacks that want to throw just to wide open guys or maybe their target receiver. But the truth of the matter is, I feel as high school coaches, we need to develop our quarterbacks to be able to read defense and identify blitzes and things of that nature. And he has done that thus far. And again, I've set high expectations for him, and he's definitely meeting them thus far.
All right. And looking at the schedule a little bit, it seems like you guys are diving right in to this Central Section slate, Visalia, Central Valley Christian, Bakersfield Christian, you know, some games that we look at that schedule, we get excited about. How do you feel about some of those teams you're playing, some of those big games that you guys are just, you know, going 0 to 100 right away?
Well, the truth of the matter is we're not going to shy away from competition. We'll play anyone, anywhere, at any time. And if we want to be at the Division I level, then we have to play the Division I level from the get-go. And really, it'll be a measuring stick to see exactly where we're at as a team and as a program.
And talk about the league a little bit. It's a new league, new formation pretty much. You guys are moving from the LPL. You know, you're probably not too familiar with a lot of those teams. What's it been like getting acquainted with, you know, some of those teams that you guys are going to be facing in this new Mountain League? You know, you're going to have Atascadero, Rigetti's there again. Talk a little bit about the league.
Well, the truth of the matter, I think I'm in a beneficial situation to where I don't know the league. I don't know the competitors. I'm not wrapped up in rivalries and things of that nature. I'm focusing on the team that we play next. So whichever team that may be, whether it's a Tascadero, Paso, Reggetti, or a Royal Grande, I'll prepare for them equally the same.
Okay. And, you know, being a head coach, you have a lot of experience as a coordinator, assistant. Is there some differences that you've noticed, some things that you got to do differently as a head coach? Have you kind of been learning on the fly a little bit as a head coach? How do you feel about you know, taking
on that? Well, I've always identified. I mean, I've coached defensive side of the ball and have been very much involved in special teams and in previous positions at different programs. And so I believe I've always been a head coach to a certain degree, because the truth of the matter, to be a very good offensive coordinator, you have to know defense, you have to know schemes and things of that nature. But I will say sometimes I will get a little too consumed offensively and have to, you know, come to the realization that I got to see both sides of the ball and obviously have a very focal point in special teams.
All right. Well, thank you for your time, Coach. August 17th, you guys are in Visalia, so good luck there and good luck the rest of the season.
Joe, thank you very much.